Well, hello, ladies and gentlemen. It's wonderful for you to join us. It's another blisteringly hot afternoon in Baku, the capital of Azerbaijan, which have been our fantastic hosts for the ISSF combined World Cup of Rifle, Pistol and Shotgun. It is day two, and it's the fourth final. I'm your commentator, Jack J, and with me this afternoon, I'm very happy to welcome Bernard Yale. Good afternoon, Bernard.
Good afternoon from Baku.
Thank you very much for joining us for this Trap Men's event. This shotgun final is about 2 hours earlier than yesterday, and already I can feel there's a big difference in the temperature. It's a hot afternoon right now.
It's very, very hot afternoon. There are no covers. The shooters have been out there for 2 days, 3 days, some of them 5-6 days training, and it's very much going to be something about stamina.
We have a very interesting lineup of finalists. My colleague Danny Potts is introducing them right now, so let's find out who's in this final. The Smikov, first time in a final round, great opportunity for this athlete from the Russian Federation. Beijing 2 years ago, 25 years of age, not his first time in the final round, but looking to get in the medal positions this afternoon. Another first time in the final six. So our most experienced athlete in the final this afternoon, as we said, a two-time World Cup gold medalist, Erik Varga from Slovakia. A great achievement. Previous best was 63rd place, so a great jump for Berti. Place in Gabala, so great to see another athlete joining a very elite group. So as I said, we've got one athlete with extremely high World Cup pedigree, but that was mentioned as well. Our athlete from Poland went through a grueling seven-way shoot-off to be here. This afternoon, the qualification scores were very good, very high, but unbelievably close as well.
Well, the thing is now, all that doesn't matter anymore because we're down to 15 targets. And for some of these shooters, the most important 15 targets they've ever shot in their lives.
Absolutely, yes. Of course, they're here for days and the grueling sun, making sure they can have this opportunity. But all that's wiped clean. They all start from zero. And the fantastic thing about that is whether you've got World Cup pedigree, whether you're an Olympic champion, or whether you're here for the very first time, everybody starts from exactly the same place.
That's a great thing for the people who've managed to just sneak into the finals. And sometimes it can be a lot of pressure for the person who's led up to this point.
Yes, exactly that. And we talk about it quite a lot on the commentary, the difference that it can make when you come into a final. Obviously, if you have the experience, it's a fantastic thing. You can lean on that experience. But you also have that level of expectation that perhaps someone who's making their debut appearance doesn't have.
Well, yeah, I mean, where they think, you know, there's a very famous line from Gary Player, the golfer, who says, whether you think you can or you can't, you're absolutely right. And at this very moment, that thought is likely to be going through their minds.
So the first round, very important for athletes to find a rhythm and make a good start. At the moment, half the field registering misses. So Smikov, Chennai with hits.
No, I'd love to get a reading of their heartbeats at the moment to see what's going on in there.
Exactly, and I mean, especially for those guys that are making their first appearance, it's a big moment. Round one is gone. Not the perfect start for athletes. Erik Varga, who we mentioned, hugely accomplished athlete, dropping the first target. Smikov, who made a great start, dropping his second target. I expect we're going to see a little bit of movement in the positions as we go on. This is not going to be a straightforward final, that's for sure.
It never is. I think, you know, we've got the first five shots where, you know, the shooter's trying to settle down, and sometimes you might take one shot to settle down, sometimes you might take five.
So, of course, this is our semi-final matchup. 15 targets, as we already stated, and then the top two athletes will go into our gold and silver medal matchup, and third and fourth will go into our bronze medal matchup, and fifth and sixth place will be decided at the end of this semi-final. and at this second round of targets. Now the rhythm is starting to be seen, although we've got another miss there for Borvan. From this point on, perhaps things will start to settle down. It's a very windy spot here by the coast. I know that my colleague Danny mentioned that in Gabala, the heat was the same, but the levels of wind was much less. I guess the coastal position means it was windy. How was it out there on the field of play?
Very windy. I've been told that Baku is called the city of winds.
Right, okay.
And it is very windy, but in some ways that's welcome because it's so hot out here. I mean, it's wonderful having all the sunshine, but it is incredibly hot.
Yeah, we're registering at least kind of 30, 31 degrees. It hasn't really shifted from that all day. And you're absolutely right. That little bit of breeze, I think, will help these athletes who, at a minimum, are out here for 45, it could be 50 minutes. We mentioned our athlete that went through that shoot-off. It's a long day in the heat. So we now move on to the fourth round of targets. At the moment, the only athlete to still have a perfect start is Gianmarco Berti from San Marino. He's made a wonderful start to this final. Everybody else at least registering one hit, some with two. Erik Varga now, he remains with one miss, so still very much in contention. Here comes Berti, fantastic hit.
He's clear 4 out of 4 so far.
That's exactly what you want to see. And as I say, a remarkable jump in fortune from him. His previous World Cup best was 63rd place in Nicosia. So whatever happens today, Bertie's going to end up with a career best, that's for sure. A nice rhythm at the moment, no equipment issues. We had a trap women's event, a couple of points where it just slows up, and that's where I think you really start to test the mentality of athletes. Is, you know, you can set your own rhythm, I suppose, but if something happens which is untoward, there's nothing you can do about that. How do you deal with something like that?
All you can do is reset yourself and do, you know, go through your routine which you've relied on to get to this point, and that's really all you can do.
So at 5 targets, a slight pause in play for announcements in the arena. Gianmarco Berti with a fantastic start, so no misses. The perfect start, you would say, but look how close it is behind him. Smikov, Shinai, Varga, all with one miss each. And even our lowest ranking athletes are still only with two misses, Borvan and Kowalski. So very, very close indeed. This is what we like to see at this stage. We've still got 10 to go, but I wouldn't like to call at the moment who's going to walk away into those gold medal matches.
It's a long, long way to go. Well, it's for someone like Berti, it's nice to be at this point where you've settled down and you haven't dropped any targets yet, but it's still some time to go.
No mistake about that as a hit from Kowalczyk. Very confident shooting at the moment. You can see they're feeling at ease out there, most of these competitors. And the nice thing is, you can't really pick, you know, you wouldn't say that someone is oozing, you know, debut fear or someone else is particularly confident. They look equal out there.
Well, for today, these are the 6 best in the world. So, you know, regardless of how they're feeling inside, I mean, from the outside, they look really calm and in control of their game. But I'm pretty sure heart's pounding. Heart's pounding.
They're doing a good job of keeping it on the inside.
Absolutely.
Yeah, the shooting poker face is something which I'm kind of starting to become accustomed to. You know, people may be particularly emotional or people, but they keep it locked inside.
Well, if the cameras get close enough, you might see some hands shaking out there, but it's certainly there's no symptom of that in the shooting at the moment because everybody's cleared the last 10 targets, the last 9 targets have been cleared.
Yep, absolutely. Round 6, round 7, if it's a hit for Borvan. Perfect shooting. Now they've found a rhythm. Now it's going to be extremely close. And this is where making a perfect start can start to really make a nice difference. For you as an athlete, I often am intrigued because I know that you can start to anticipate the pattern of what you're going to see. Are you someone that does that, or do you like to just clear that from your head and just shoot what you see, in front of you?
Well, for me, all I try and do is just take each shot as the first shot.
Okay.
You know, and it's a nice bonus when you're midway through the round and things feel like they're settling down. And sometimes as you reach the last sort of set of targets, you know, you start there's a temptation there to kind of think about the end of the round and how many you could have shot or not. But I think the only thing you can do is just reset and just do it again and do it again, which is what these guys have proven they're really good at doing.
Well, spectacular set of shooting. The last three rounds, no misses from any of our athletes continuing here. And these guys aren't just clipping these targets. They're getting absolutely smashed. And really, condition-wise, apart from perhaps some fatigue from the heat, you can't ask for much more. This shooting range is pretty spectacular, as the viewers can see from these images. But when you're out here, it's as close to perfection as you can get.
It's an incredible range. I don't think there's a single range anywhere in the world which has this sort of consistency of field. I mean, the whole thing is... I'm not sure you can see it on the TV channel, but it's completely astroturf.
Exactly. So look at that. Just perfect lines of sight. Because sometimes you get ranges where the grass is there, but you maybe have some trees or something breaking up. But look at those lines, so clean. That must be helpful for you as an athlete.
Well, we've just had one miss.
So the first miss in a while. Chennai after an excellent start. He was one of the athletes who was only on one miss, so it's not too bad at the moment. It means he'll move down into a tie for our bottom-ranking athletes. But he's the first one. He's the first one to slip in quite a while.
So no target there. That's going to disrupt things a little bit.
We had this issue yesterday a little bit. If it's one, it shouldn't be too bad. Sometimes the heat can play havoc with the clays as well. I think someone was mentioning that it just kind of softens them up a little bit, that can make them slightly more brittle. So we've had 10 targets, and that second section of five series, quite incredible. Just one drop target, which is amazing. So that means that Kanan Chennai will move down into a tie for fourth position. At the moment, on his own, Herb Bovan in sixth place. But look at this, so close. Second place is a tie, and remaining in first place, zero misses, Gian Marco Berti. Fantastic start to this final, and well beyond the midway stage. So he must be feeling pretty confident.
I always think, when there's five targets left, we're only halfway through the round psychologically, because that's when the expectations start to creep in. So although there's some separation in the scores at the moment, I it's still too close to call.
Places to make a debut appearance in the final round. I feel as though the athletes might be slightly spoiled here. As we said, the conditions are very, very good.
I think Chennai just had two no birds, but he's composed himself really, really well and hit that target.
If you prep yourself to take the shot and then you get two in a row like that, you have to try and keep the concentration level absolutely spot on, otherwise it can cost you.
It's tricky because he missed the one before previously, and that can play on your mind after having two no birds. But clearly he's at the top of his game and recomposed himself and destroyed that target, pretty much.
Kinan Chennai is a relatively young athlete in this field, 25 years of age, and we mentioned before we came on air that there's a nice mix of ages out there. Bovin from France, although not a huge amount of World Cup experience, as it were, sixth place in Gabala, 46 years of age. It's nice to see.
I think it's a wonderful sport that you've got such a wide range of ages being able to compete at international level for so long.
Yeah, you were saying yourself that you're very happy that you're still able to be competing at the top level. It's a wonderful sport in that respect that you can continue to.
It is. I mean, like you said, you've got a field here with almost 20 years of difference. Something's gone wrong here.
So we have a slight discrepancy here, which has been spotted by our coaches. One of our jury members is on his feet.
Okay, this is.
We have a misrepresented miss.
I think at this point, it's the tension's going to really build now. I mean, you've got three targets left, and this is the point at which there's a chance that the shooters are thinking about the possibility of maybe making the final, or making the goal final, or not.
Try to disconnect you and let you see if this screen better.
So the business end of proceedings has to be said. This will be the end of the round of 12 targets. Three athletes now holding a tie for first position, with Berti dropping one for the first time. So we had a red flag from our referees. No confirmation of that on the scoreboard just yet. Hey. So a slight pause in proceedings here. I believe it's Chennai that's waiting to shoot. You know, these are the things that you just can't take into account. You can train for this sort of thing, but when it happens to you, you have to kind of take it on the chin and hope that you can step up, like he does there. Fantastic, good for him. That's not the first time in this final he's had to work with a disruption. So a confirmation of that 13th target for Smikov was a miss. And that means, looking at it, if things don't change, we are going to need to have a shoot-off to decide our medal match positions as it stands right now. So the final targets coming out now. Our athletes taking advantage of that. No misses so far. It's nice to finish on a high in the semi-final, I would imagine. Oh. So it looks like we have our two athletes that are going to be in that gold medal matchup.
So we have a shoot-off at the moment.
So let's see. End of the semi-final.
So we have a three-way shoot-off for the bronze.
Precisely. So massive congratulations to Erik Varga and to Gianmarco Berti, who goes straight through into our gold medal match. And as being confirmed by the announcements in the arena, there is going to be a shoot-off for that bronze medal match. Not the first one we've seen today, and the one that we did see, it wasn't quick. There's excellent shooters out there. So Smikov, Kowalczyk, and Bovan are going to be involved in the shoot-off. A confirmation of the two athletes that are leaving the competition now. The tie for...
So we got Varga or Berti and a gold medal match.
Exactly.
And so they're both medal winners. I mean, it must be a very comforting thought to...
Well, we were talking about this earlier on, exactly that, in the rifle final, and to an athlete, as soon as you know that you're in that medal-winning position, what a huge difference it makes.
Well, we saw, I don't know if you saw it on the screen, but, you know, there was a lot of cheering going on after the first, after the final was over.
Exactly, a huge sigh of relief, a kind of a nice release.
Has Berti been in a final before, or is it...
So if we look at, well, he,
oh, wow.
No,
okay.
What a huge jump
so
for
first
him.
First final and
his very first
medal.
Final, exactly. And it's, you know, a first top 10 finish. Now it's going to be a first medal. It's an amazing, amazing achievement from San Marino, a wonderfully proud country that wonderfully hosted a World Cup earlier on this year. But not the biggest country, so they'll be very, very pleased to have a gold medal, a medal winner, shall we say. So we're now looking at the shoot-off. And this is to decide who will be going into that bronze medal final. Only two of the athletes can go in, and one of them will be taking fifth place. So a good start. That's exactly what you want in a shoot-off. Get the first one out of the way. There aren't many second chances in these kind of things.
No. This is it. This is the only chance these guys are going to have for this competition to get a medal. And in many ways, the bronze medal match is more dramatic in some ways, because you're talking about the difference between going back with something, or you know, with something, an achievement, or going back feeling that you ought to have done better.
Exactly. I think you're absolutely right. Many athletes have mentioned it before. Obviously, everybody wants to take home a gold, but at the start of the competition, if they offered you a silver, I think you know people would bite their hand off. But you're right. There is no worse position in a way than fourth. You come so close, but yet so far. And look at them. They're clearly focused. No targets dropped so far. So it's a most certainly a personal best for all three of these athletes. Bovin, his previous personal best was sixth place last year in Gabala. And for other two athletes, they make their debut. That's a miss for Smikov. So over to you, Kowalczyk. Hit it and you stay in.
We've done a great job to get to this point, considering there were 120. How many shooters were there in the men's competition?
It was a high amount, yeah, over 100 for sure.
Yeah.
It's a big field. It's been given as a hit. There was a quiver of the flag on this left-hand side, but it's been given as a hit. So Bovin, poised. And a hit for him. Takes himself, Herb Bovin, and Kowalczyk into our bronze medal final. So an excellent day for both of those. And that miss on target number three for Maxim Smikov means that he will take fifth place in this final. And I imagine, even though he'll be disappointed at the moment, he'll be pleased with that. His first time in the final round, he's been working his way up. He's had a very relatively successful start to 2016. Ninth place in San Marino, 15th place in Rio. And this is the kind of progression that I'm sure an athlete would love to see now, finding himself taking fifth place. It's all going in the right direction for him.
Well, absolutely. I mean, there's nothing... It's an amazing achievement to be in the top 10 in any World Cup, let alone make the final. He will feel a certain amount of regret that he, you know, didn't progress any further than this. But nevertheless, it's an incredible achievement.
So they're just preparing the athletes for our bronze medal matchup. And it's been non-stop for these guys. Qualification. And Kowalczyk involved in the shoot-off, then another shoot-off, and then a bronze medal match.
Well, he's definitely earned his place, that's for sure.
Most certainly. So a recap on the two athletes of Bovin. He was the most senior, shall we say, athlete to appear this afternoon, 46 years young, and Kowalczyk, 28 years of age, first time in the final round, so a little bit more experience. Although, in actual fact, Kowalczyk started competing a year before Bovin. He just has, you know, he's given himself a little bit more time to appear in the final round, but now he's looking to make an impact, I'm sure. And how did you find your time out there on the range today during qualification?
Great. I mean, it's great to be here to shoot in such facilities. I mean, it's one of the grounds which I've been really wanting to attend at, and to get this chance is great.
They've made huge leap forwards here. Baku, it seems, as a city, has massive sporting aspirations. We were. The lead up to the shooting World Cup was the Formula One Grand Prix being right in the center of town. I know some of the athletes got their flights brought forward a little bit so they could stay and watch that. And the infrastructure, the level of commitment and effort that's been put in for this range is truly admirable. You know, this is a beacon of something which we'd, you know, love to see all over the world, really. It's incredible. If you have a few hundred million pounds to spend, of course.
Well, I suppose you could say it's with the sort of weather we have here, it might be easier to have AstroTurf than to have to keep the grass watered.
Yes.
But that's a big field out there. It's unusually, with the 76 meter markers where the targets are going to, it seems like that's in the middle of the field, which is really unusual. Normally they're right at the end. It's an absolutely huge, huge arena.
It just seems to go on and on and on and on. And like we say, these perfect lines for visibility, for everything, is absolutely, absolutely awesome. We've got a little break in play. So some of our spectators are being made to wait a little bit longer for the bronze medal match. But here come our athletes. They are ready to go. They're going to be officially introduced in just a second. But Herve Bovin from France, definitely beating his personal best. But it's as a tense final. No one wants to go home. If you've made it this far, you want to push across the line and take home that bronze medal.
Yeah, this is a tough one. To go back with something you can remember, something tangible you can hold on to. I mean, sure, everybody here will go back with memories, good and bad.
Yep.
But to have that medal in your hands would be quite something.
And of course, this week there's been a lot of talk about the Olympic Games. We have less than 45 days to go, I think, so the Rio Olympics are kind of right on top of us. A lot of the countries, even though they have their quota places, are keeping their squad announcements close to their chest. Of course, for these guys with the CV, maybe not, they're going to be in contention. But what a wonderful experience, and it's nice for them to maybe ask some questions of their coaches just before the big show, as it were, and showing that they're what they're made of.
Yeah, I'm sure the selections have already been done. keeping quite tight-lipped about it, but
yes.
I'm pretty sure it's been done.
Yes, exactly. So, little break, but they step straight up. Two hits, strong start. And they still be looking to get into a nice rhythm. France put a pretty sizable squad with them, so they'll be pleased to see somebody in the final. I think it's the first appearance of a French athlete in the final, even though it is day two, so there's still plenty more opportunities. Some of the nations choosing to rest people before the games. Others hoping to get some extra practice in, as it were, before the Olympic Games.
So this is a little bit more familiarity for Kowalczyk now. He's been through the toil of a final, and effectively this is his second final now.
Yeah. Three targets down, perfect start, three hits, zero misses, keeps it at a tie. I would suspect this is going to go right down to the wire. The semi-final yesterday was decided by, I think, only two targets. One of the finals yesterday was decided by only one target. And I think that's what makes it so hard to take if you are the guy that drops a target, knowing that perhaps that could be the difference between fourth place and a medal to go home with. And there is indeed the first miss.
They seem to have settled right down.
Yes.
Compared to the semi-finals.
Either of these athletes will be disappointed to have to go home now. They've worked so hard to get in here. He responds with a hit, so it is only a single drop target at the moment. And make no mistake about it, even though there were some unfamiliar names in the final, there were some big names in the field. There were some big names in the shoot-off, in actual fact. People have turned out for this World Cup. It was no easy task making it to the final.
We've had a inquiry on whether the target was hit. Oh, it's been decided
Martins,
that it was a miss.
As a miss.
Yeah.
So that brings us back to all square. If Bovin can hit this target, which he can. So we've had six targets, and we're back to a tie. Amazingly close. There are only 15 regulation final targets, and then of course we're going to shoot off a shoot-off scenario. Target seven, well taken, Kowalczyk. And a miss, another miss for Bovin. It almost has a shoot-off feel to it. It's so close, you feel as though these misses are kind of make or break. Of course, a miss is only any good if the other athlete can take advantage of it. Kowalczyk has that opportunity now, and he does. Has. Needs to just clear his head.
And he hasn't.
And he hasn't. Two in a row for Bovin. It's a long walk round to station one after that. It's a shame. He's been an excellent competitor so far. No matter what happens, he'll be very happy. But with an improvement, but I'm sure in the short term.
There's still seven targets to go. And
exactly.
Long way before the end.
So, we've had nine, three of them dropped by Bovin. It still only means there's a two-target advantage, which, with the amount that we have left, is enough to protect, you would have to say. But after the length of day that we've had for these guys, it wouldn't surprise me whatsoever if we saw at least a shortening of that lead.
Well, with the last five targets, the expectations are definitely going to be there. There is certainly going to be a glimmer of a thought about a medal going through their heads and having to push that out and get on with the job at hand. And that's exactly what they've both done.
So we've had 10, five to go, so still a third of the competition targets. You know, the finish line is in sight, but it's certainly not upon them. Must be said that Kowalczyk has had a fantastic final here. Slight slip in the middle, but it's consistent. There's miss number four for Bovin.
Kowalczyk's three ahead with four to go, right? Yep.
A couple more hits, and it will be his. Needs to keep it together for the next couple of targets. Doesn't look like shifting at the moment. No, Very confident.
He looks really well composed. He looks relaxed.
So we've had 12 targets which have passed. Still a single miss for Kowalczyk. So at the moment, you have to say if he does finish up in a bronze medal position, well deserved, a fantastic final that he's shot. Can he continue? Yes, he can.
Yep.
And that applause from the stand signifies that in fact it is not confirmed officially, but Kowalczyk can't catch him up now. So now they're playing for their records. Little spurts of rhythm, two hits, but it's those two in a row in the middle, I think, which really cost him dearly.
Well, the standard of shooting is so high that it's rare to win a 15 target format with less than 13 targets hit.
So Kowalczyk steps up for the final target for him in this bronze medal final. He'd love to finish with a hit. It's been so cool so far.
Prepare for the cheering. That's pretty premature with that one.
He's so good that he's even the hit before they even come out. Well, that's done. A great shot. Congratulations to Kowalczyk. A brilliant, brilliant performance in this bronze medal match. The final target. It is a hit from Bovan. He takes fourth place. And a wave to the crowd for Puerta Kowalczyk. It's a bronze medal for him. And a truly, truly fantastic change of fortunes for him. His previous best, 21st place in Munich over 2 years ago. And here he is at the 2016 World Cup in Baku. He'll be going home with a little bit of extra hand luggage in the shape of a bronze medal. So congratulations to him. There it is, some proud coaches and team members being brought out. He's immediately has the Polish flag thrown on him. Wonderful scenes, a very proud moment. Some of that Baku wind being put to good use, flying the flag. So congratulations to them both. Hopefully we'll have a slightly quicker start to our gold medal match. And two people who have who had an amazing final to get here. Gianmarco Berti and Erik Varga going head to head to find out who'll be taking home the gold medal. As you say, they have the relief of knowing that they have a medal, whichever way you cut it. It hasn't been a wasted trip, but for Gianmarco Berti, a huge opportunity. His first time in the final round. As we say, he's already made the hop, skip and a jump from 63rd place best in Nicosia in 2013 to a position here in a gold medal matchup. But if he wants to get his hands on that gold medal, he's going to have to go through the most experienced shooter that is here. He's ranked fourth in the world. And at 40 years old, he has a wealth of experience that he's going to need this afternoon. A great athlete, great competitor.
Well, he certainly showed his experience in that semi-final.
Yes, exactly. So the official presentation begins. So there you see. First of all, Erik Varga from Slovakia. His last World Cup medal was, in fact, 2 years ago. Silver medal in Almaty. It's been 3 years since his last gold. So he'll want to add one more to his tally for sure. And Varga is a competitor who most certainly will have Olympic aspirations. So that's somebody who will want to be gaining precious last-minute experience in the final round.
I'm sure he'll be there.
He'll be there. He'll be looking to be repeating this in the and make it to a final round. But my goodness, the competition is going to be strong over there. First targets were decisive in the last round. Two hits, good start. They've been on the sidelines for a few minutes, so maybe just settle some of those nerves. And
well, they've had a little bit of time to rest after that semi-final and this heat. Well, Berti is definitely decisive in the way he prepares for his shot. The gun goes up and target's called, no time wasted.
It's interesting, the obviously it's a complete personal preference. Are you conditioned by your coaches and your training as to how much time you should take, or is it something which is sort of a personal evolution on time before you make the call?
It varies so much. I mean, you've got people like Fernandez who calls within no time, literally as soon as the gun touches his cheek, he calls a target.
Miss there for Berti. And we were just talking up his
yes.
technique.
Yes.
So he's down by one. There's still a long way to go. 12 targets left. But you're absolutely right. Not as quick as maybe as Fernandez, but it's a pretty swift. We're looking at 3 seconds before it's called until he makes the call. Gun goes up. Bang. 10 seconds. Yeah. 2.5 seconds between gun going up and calling for the target. He's someone who's been competing for a long time, so certainly no lack of competition experience in Berti, but in finals experience, most certainly. He makes his way around the back of our referee to begin the cycle again as Varga prepares.
It's definitely a very spectacular style of shooting. It looks so decisive and committed. I guess, you know, shooting that quickly, you don't really have time for any doubts to get into your head.
No, exactly. That's a very good point, yeah. It seems to, it's a little bit of an illusion, but it certainly oozes confidence. When you watch it from the outside, someone that just snaps their gun up and, you know, the target's gone before you've seen it. So no change in the standings. That single miss separating these two athletes. Erik Varga with a magnificent start to this gold medal match. He looks seriously calm. He doesn't look like somebody that's in a final round. He looks like he's on his on his range at home.
It's a really, really precise and composed style. It's nice seeing two different styles in the final.
Target 8, 2 hits. So at the moment, still just separated by that one target. And if it does work out that's the way, that's certainly no shame in going down to such an experienced shooter, and he'll be very pleased with what he's achieved today. But as it stands at the moment, he's fighting tooth and nail to make sure that he can put up a challenge for that gold medal. Have you had the process of sharing a range with these guys in qualification at any point or not? Or is it?
I think I've been on the same squad as Varga in the past.
Okay.
But I'm not sure if I've shot with Berti before. But you tend not to notice who's on your squad.
Right. Okay. You're focused on your own.
Well, you're trying to. I think if you're totally aware of everything which is going on in your squad, something's wrong.
Varga making light work of the first 10 targets. Really, really strong showing. And, well, I talked that one up, didn't I?
You know, I was just about to say that Varga looked like this unstoppable force, which was, you know, precise. Well,
I hope that Eric doesn't listen back to this, because we probably aren't going to be on his Christmas card list. A first missed target for Erik Varga. And I take my hat off to Gianmarco Berti. He dropped the target, he didn't let his head drop, he kept his concentration, and look where we are. After 11 targets, it's now even again. So that's why you must keep your concentration until the very, very last target. Huge boost for Berti. 12 targets gone, and Erik Varga now will be ruining number 11. He was nearly ready for a nice trip to the hotel, but this is going to go right to the wire.
Now at this point, you know, if I'm sitting on the spectators area normally, I'd be looking at the shooters really closely to see if there's any little hint of any sense that extra nervousness or lack of composure, but these guys are absolutely on their game.
And certainly no change in the speed of Berti. Even at this stage, that's obviously his style and he's sticking with it. There's no hesitation whatsoever. Both seems super confident.
A little hesitation from Berti then.
Oh, he still takes it in the nick of time.
Well, that's a sign of being precise with your preparation. It wasn't right. He put his gun down, put it back up again, and hit the target. Exactly what you should have done.
No intimidation from the shot clock whatsoever.
So I'm not going to say anything about any unstoppable force or anything at this point, because this is
this is
the last target.
Final target. Oh, it's no target. The no targets have built the tension even more today.
That's definitely going to add a little layer of tension on top. He knows he has to hit this one.
Okay, here we go. Target 15. Final of regulation. very confidently hit from Erik Varga. So Berti must hit this target to remain in. And he does. No tension building from Gianmarco Berti.
But no chance to commentate very much on what he's doing, because the gun goes up and the target's out and he's hit it.
Absolutely.
That's a great score. 14 each.
14 each, exactly. One miss. Huge amount of respect for both of these guys. No drop in pace or intensity from either of those. And you can see the... He's removed his hat. Look at that sheen of sweat that's on him. Yeah. I don't blame him for taking a little wipe of the towel. We're lucky enough to be in the shade right now, but it's still very, very warm out there. It's been a real credit to the discipline today. They've kept the speed up. The intensity they've shown has been absolutely fantastic. And you know, you've got the top two guys in the field right now. They don't want to make it easy for one another. So even though that final felt very much like a shoot-off, it is definitely missing your out right now. Berti steps up. Confidently takes it down.
Judging by the way they've been shooting, this is going to take a while.
Yes. Looks like our guys in the stands are getting comfortable because, yeah, no lack of confidence from these shooters.
I think we better get the picnic out.
Yeah, I think you're absolutely right. You need to come well prepared with such talent on display if you're going to come out to the field of play. Having said that, the man who has been so consistent throughout, Erik Varga, drops his target. Could be a big moment for Gianmarco Berti. Chance for a first World Cup gold.
He's hit it.
My goodness! For a split second, that looked like a hit.
We can't quite see it from this because our view is hidden by the ski tower.
Exactly, we're just obscured, so we're taking our markers from the referees. My goodness, what an opportunity! And with someone like Varga, you might not get another.
No, you might not. But you know, we've said a few things now, and we've been proved completely wrong 1 second later. So.
The first slip didn't prove to be too costly for Erik Varga. He'll feel as though he's used one of his 9 lives there, I think. He might not get another opportunity like that. Put this much in to a day of qualification, to a semi-final, to a final, they'll both be absolutely desperate to be the man that comes out on top, no doubt. It's always worth mentioning as well the coaches, the guys that have to go through the agony of willing on every single shot without even being able to really control what it is they're doing. You know, they put all this hard work in with the athletes, but really at this stage there's nothing they can do.
Well, it must be so much more stress being a coach, sitting there looking at your shooters and having no ability to control the situation at all.
Exactly.
Just notice there's music playing quite loudly. I mean, is that quite normal in the finals?
Well, it's been a feature of the last couple of finals. I believe in Rio there was music, and in Gabala. But this is another one that's popular. There's a DJ at the top of the stands, so The more casual members of the audience are having a little bit of background music. I don't know how that will be affecting the shooters. I mean, I'm sure they'll be trying to zone that out as much as possible.
I mean, I remember them trying a competition years ago where they had all the spectators screaming and shouting as loudly as they wanted to. That was quite a sight.
Yeah. Well, I think it's something that they're encouraging. There's a lot of emotion. The Slovakian coach is up on his feet.
Can shoot off. I think there's an issue about getting more ammunition.
Yeah, we saw a refill, I think, even before the one of the other shoot-offs. So their accuracy might be hindered slightly if they're reduced to throwing stones as opposed to using their own shells.
Oh! I think the way these guys shoot, they'll still hit them with the stones.
Yes. I think they'd probably be more accurate with a stone than I would be with a precise shotgun, I have to say. Absolutely incredible. You know, you take this level for granted, really. But look at this now. A single drop target in the last eight in a shoot-off when the pressure's on. It's remarkable.
Well, you've got a target which is, you know, a couple of inches, few inches across, you know, exiting at 71 miles an hour. And the percentage of hits these guys are making, it really puts the whole game in perspective on how difficult it is. And most beginners, when they first come onto the range and try something like Olympic trap, they might hit three, maybe one, two targets.
Yeah. Again, it's wow. Erik Varga okay. That makes the first slip.
That's a pretty nasty target, a slow left target going out there.
So once again, it's over to you, Gianmarco Berti, with an opportunity to take home a first ever World Cup gold medal. He's done it!
Oh, he's done it. He's done
Look
it.
Look how happy he is. The two athletes shake hands. The coach is on the pitch, on the field of play. Wonderful scenes. Congratulations, Gianmarco Berti. He's been competing since 1996, but it's 2016 where he takes home his first World Cup gold medal.
It's wonderful to see that change from that utter composure and that very calculated move to this burst of emotion when the result is complete.
You forget, yeah, exactly, just how much it means to them and just how much they've been suppressing all that emotion. Congratulations to Berti. Congratulations as well to Erik Varga. He made an absolutely fantastic final. He pushed Gianmarco Berti to the very, very end. He goes home with a silver medal, and congratulations. And, a wonderful final. A little bit longer than expected, but well worth it when you see that level of shooting. Bernard, it's our first time working together. I'm sure it won't be our last. Thank you so much for joining us this afternoon. It's been wonderful to have you.
Thanks very much.
Absolute pleasure. Well, from myself, from Bernard, and from the entire team here in Azerbaijan, for now, at this combined World Cup, it's goodbye.
Ladies and gentlemen, the fixture ceremony of the trap men's event is ISSF World Cup Baku 2016 will take place at the Awards Pavilion. So just the other side of all the stands here at the Awards Pavilion, the victory ceremony, and that's at 4 o'clock or as soon as we can go. So 4 o'clock, please. If you're going to ask us, please make sure that we're over at the Awards Pavilion just before 4 o'clock, if possible. So please come and support your medalists and congratulate them on their victories today. So
Perché non c'era?